here in Aiken County.
Great to be back in Aiken. It's always a great crowd, a rambunctious crowd here in Aiken. They like to have a good time, so it's awesome. Always good to have them get in touch with our fan base, but more than anything, just say thank you. We got the most loyal, passionate fan base in the country. It's just a small form of thank you from me.
Talk to us a little bit about how you plan on building on the momentum of last year. You've got your 9-win season. How you guys plan on, you know, keeping it going?
Well, you got to recruit well, number one. I think we've done that. I think we've improved our roster. I think that we had a very good spring. I've been pleased with the progress we've made. We've got to continue to make that progress. We've got about 50 guys on campus in May, and starting June 4th, our entire team will be back. So looking forward to having a great summer. That leads into having a great training camp, which affords you the opportunity to have a great season, and our guys need to understand that.
How do you plan on, you know, competing with other, you know, SEC teams? You know, Georgia's on the rise. You know, you've always got other teams there.
Really worried about South Carolina. That's all I'm really worried about is our preparation and what we need to do to be successful. That's all I can be concerned with. And if we'll go prepare the right way, we have a chance to have a good football team. But, you know, a lot of things have to happen in that for that to happen.
I want to get your thoughts just on the spring and specifically on offense. What's the special
thing? Well, I really like, you know, playing them faster. I think helps us. I think the progress of our offensive line has been very good. We need to have more depth in the offensive line, but I do like our skill position people outside. I think Jake Bentley plays better when we play faster, and I think we've got a good stable of backs and some good tight ends. I mean, I think we have the makings to have a pretty good offensive football team, but we need to continue to progress. We were never at full speed as far as the receiver position is concerned for Jake, so the timing needs to be there throughout summer leading into fall camp.
Taekwon Johnson's from this area, so I want to get your thoughts.
Yeah,
on him.
Excited about him, a big explosive receiver, a guy that he came and earned his scholarship. He came to camp and earned it. We really liked his film. He's a vertical guy that can go down and attack the ball down the field, very athletic, a guy that we're really excited about. He came to camp, he worked out as good as any of the big receivers we had in camp in the last 2 years.
When those guys come to camp, is there one thing you look for, whatever the position is there something that you say?
I think position criteria, Josh, depends on what position we're talking about, but work ethic. You know, I want to see a guy work. We coach him extremely hard in camp, and there'll be some guys that don't really want to work. And if they don't want to work, they don't need to come to us. They need to go somewhere else. You know, we work them just like we're going to work our guys when we work them out in August camp, and we're a normal week of practice. So I think, you know, there's different position specific things we're looking for, but coachability, learnability, and football IQ, and are they willing to work?
When did you have to come to camp and we have to see you in person become sort of a – that's pretty much everybody's criteria now, right?
I would think so.
When did that become a thing?
I don't know that it's with everybody, but I think it holds true with a lot of guys if you're unsure about the tape, if you're unsure about the competition, if you're unsure about the area. You want to be able to see a guy perform in camp. But I think because of all the intangible things I talked about earlier, that's part of it too. And you can get fooled by the film. So you got to be careful about that and really look towards the work ethic and the type of things that they're willing to put in.
How is Jalen Dickerson coming in his recovery?
Right now he's on time for everything. He hasn't obviously been cleared for contact. We'll know more about that in August, but everything to this point has been exactly where it needs to be. So, I've been pleased so far with what I've heard, but he's got full range of motion. He's getting most of his strength back, and they think he's on time for everything.
Y'all had such high hopes for him after last spring. Do those still exist, or
absolutely.
Is it going to take a while?
I mean, absolutely. The guy's a good football player and would have played for us this year. That's what's killing us right now at the safety position. Here's a guy that would have played for us last year and been on all special teams, and he's missed a year of experience. But it is what it is. That's the situation. We've got to make it work.
Y'all put out a video earlier today, I guess, of the freshmen and the impact they made last year. Any of those guys surprise you at how much they were able to contribute or what they were able to do?
We recruit guys to play. If you're good enough, you'll play. If you're the best of your position, you'll start. I don't care if you're a freshman. I don't care where you're from. It doesn't really matter to me. It's about putting the best players on the field to give us an opportunity to win games.
You know, I guess Shy worked as some of the outside receiver this position this spring. How much do you plan on moving him around some, or was that just kind of experimental?
I think it's always about creating depth on your football team. It's not about putting the next guy on the depth chart in. It's about putting the next best player. So if Shy can play both outside and inside, that helps our football team. So if we do have an injury or we do have somebody that's not ready to play in a certain position, we're putting the best guy in the position to be successful. That's what spring ball is for, is to build depth on your football team.